heard of the range, right? It's the range.
Range is how much it goes to E like that.
So if you have V to W, right, and this is L, we said for a mapping, function mapping, we want all of V, right? But do we necessarily want all of W? It's a mapping into, yeah, if you want onto, and that's the next thing we'll define. But in general, you just get a little piece of this, that's the range of L, right? Okay, so let's look. It's the set of all, the range of L or the image of V under L, which is range L, consists of all those vectors W in W, so here, right, that are images of under L of vectors in V. Okay, so I said, okay, that's a picture, right? So it may be the entire W, as Narek said, if L is onto, and that's the definition we'll formalize again for linear transformation, okay? So how do we write this in symbols? Range L, how do we write this? It's the set of all W in W, right? Such that what? How do we write that this English, the English? That are images under L of vectors in V. Set of W in W such that what? W is equal to image L of V for what? For some
range W.
V in V. Isn't it? That's what it means. You can find some V in V. Does that mean can you find more than one?
Yeah.
It's okay, right? If your mapping is not one-to-one, yeah, you can have more than one V in V. Okay? So that's how you do it. And then as Narek said, you have an onto mapping, right? If what? L is onto if? What about the range of L? Range of L is the entire set or the entire space W. Okay? Good. What do you think the range of L is? Like the kernel of L, the range of L is a? It's a subset of W, right? But we can make a stronger statement than that. What stronger statement can we make? Not only is it a subset, it is also a subspace. Okay? So that's what the next theorem is saying. Okay? I'll just abbreviate this. Okay, how do we prove this? Anybody want to try? I know this is getting yucky.
Getting?
It's yucky already. No, I mean the board.
Oh.
I don't even think this thing is... No, the topic is not... So how do we show that the range of L is a subspace of W? Again, we need to show what? Two things, right? What do we want to do? Part A is what? What do we do? What?
For
we take what? How
a
many
vector L? V and vectors.
Well, let's call them W, because you have V and W, right?
Oh,
so you start with elements in W, right? How many elements in W?
Two.
So let what? Instead of V, let's call them?
A and B.
W1, W2, B in what? Not in W, but in the range of L, right? What do we want to show?
W1 plus W2.
We want to show that W1 plus W2 is also in the range of L. Okay? So how will that happen? W1 plus W2 is in the range of L. Well, if we know that W1 is in the range of L, what does that mean? By definition, what does that mean?
W1
is in the range of L by definition means that what?
It's the image of V.
And in symbols, that means what?
L of V.
That W1 is equal to what? L of
V1.
V1 for some V1 in V. Correct? Likewise, what do we say here?
W2
is in the range of L, means that we can write W2 as L of V2 for some V2 in V, right? So we want to show that W1 plus W2 is in the range of L. So now do you see what the next thing is that I will write?
W1 and W2 equal.
Then you have to form what?
L of V1 plus L of V2.
You have to do this, right? Okay, so then if you want to do this, so now, maybe you say now, W1 plus W2 is equal to what? Or actually maybe instead of, I didn't like now. The implication of these two, right? These two will imply what? These two will imply that W1 plus W2 is equal to L of V1 plus L of V2. L of V2. Okay. Oh, that's actually the best. L of V2. All right. So then you have L of V1 plus L of V2, but L being a linear transformation means what? I can put these together and I have L of V1 plus V2. So from here to here, what have we shown? That we were able to write W1 plus W2 as what? An L of something in V. Isn't this in V? Correct?
Yes.
Correct? V1 plus V2 is in V. Therefore, because we were able to exhibit this, that there is something in V whose image under L is that. Conclusion? Yes. Not yet. What is the yes? The conclusion is that W1 plus W2 is in the range of L. We're not done. Don't get carried away yet.
Can I say closure and addition?
Yeah, because of the closure, right, property. We were actually showing the closure property, right? Okay. It's closed under addition, and that's what it means, that this sum is in that set. Okay? Part B, what do we have to show? If W is in the range of L and C is a real number or a scalar, what do we want to show? Show what?
W times C.
C times W is also in the range of L, right? So the same thing that we did there, if W is in the range of L, that means to say what? We can write W as what? L of V for V for some V in. I mean, you might, maybe we could have combined these to save us some time, right? Okay, for V in V. So now if you want CW, what does CW look like? So this will imply CW, because W is L of V, will look like C times L of V, right? But because L is a linear transformation, we can write this as what? Maybe I can just write it. L of CV. But where is CV? CV is an element of V, right? Okay? This is an element of V, and so therefore, what happens? That means to say that CW, because we were able to find an element of V such that the image of that element in V of V under L is CW, that means to say that CW is in the range of L. Get it? Okay. And therefore, you're done, right? A and B will imply that range L is a subspace of V. Okay? Formation is, was it one-to-one?
Yeah. No.
No, right? This was not one-to-one. The kernel consisted of something else, right? Now, the other thing that we want to do is the range, okay? So we have three questions here. Is 3-6 in the range of L? Is 2-3 in the range of L? And then part C, find a set of vectors spanning range L. So how will you answer these? Solution? What do we do? In order to figure out if 3-6 is in the range of L, what do we want to happen? What we want to see is what? Yeah, can we find a vector, right? U1, U2, such that this is equal to 3-6, correct? Is that correct? So I heard Narek say, oh, then you just have to solve an augmented matrix, correct? Which mm-hmm. is what? 3, 6. Now part B is saying, do the same thing for 2, 3, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's the same thing, right? Can we write this equals 2, 3? So again, it's the same augmented matrix. So can I do the work in one shot?
Yes.
So A and B, I can do it here. This is A, this is B, 2, 3. And I can do my pivoting, right? Okay? So then I'll get 1, 0, 2, 3, 2, 0, 0.
-1.
3 minus 4, negative 1. Okay, let's interpret our answer here. Okay? So what's the answer to A?
Yes.
Is it yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
The answer to A is yes. The answer to B is?
Yes.
No. You understand why? Right? Because here it's a consistent system you got, right? And here you said, well, 0 cannot be negative 1. So no, 2, 3 is not in the range of F. Very good. Okay. How do we answer part C? Find a set of vectors spanning range L. So we want to look at what the range of L will look like, right? So what will the elements of range L look like? What do you have to do? Aren't these the answers in range L? So therefore, if you look at that, that's 1, 2, 2, 4, carry out the multiplication, see what answers we will get, right? So we get what form? U1 plus 2U2, 2U1 plus 4U2, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then what?
That's it, factor of the U1.
You can write it as U1, 1, 2, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Because we want a spanning set, right? Okay, plus factor out the U2, you'll have U2, 2, 4, right? So right here you say, well, every answer in the range can be written as a linear combination of 1, 2, and 2, 4, right? Therefore, what is a spanning set for the range of L?
1, 2, 4.
1, 2, 2, 4. Do you want to go further and think?
That's the basis.
This thing spans the range of L, right? But, is there a but? If you were asked to find a basis for the range of L, is that a basis for the range?
Just one of them.
You just need one, right? Because this is not linearly independent, right? That's dependent. So what's a basis? Just one,
two.
Question? You're okay? All right. So the same exercise that we talked about earlier about kernel and about one-to-one-ness. Now we want to look at the onto-ness of the linear transformation. Okay? Is this going to be onto? How do you think you're going to start your work if you want to show that this is onto? How do you begin? If a mapping is onto, you want to show that what?
The range
is the entire R3, right? Which means to say that what? If you take any, what? Take any three vector, right? Horizontal, right? Take any three vector, what do you want to call the three vector? ABC, XYZ? I don't know, what did I... like it throws us off when we use ABC, right? Okay. All you want is anything. What letter would be most comfortable with?
Alpha,
beta. I think we've been using W's for our range, right? If you take W1, W2, W3 in R3, what are we hoping to find? Can we find what? A U1, U2, right? In R2, such that what? Such that L of U1, U2 is equal to W1, W2, W3. So how do we do that? So L of U1, U2 really is what? U1,
U1
plus U2, We want that to be equal to W1, W2, W3. And of course, this takes you to a system, right, which is what? The first one says U1 is equal to W1. U1 plus U2 has to be equal to W2. U2 is equal to W3. Okay, what do you think? We are hoping to find U1, U2, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, if you remember, we did something very similar already before.
W1 plus W3 is W2. Is that what I'm going to do? Maybe? I don't know.
Yeah, so this, if you put it here, this tells you that U1 plus W3 has to be W2, right? Or, which means to say that W2 minus W3 has to be U1. When you say this has to be, is that good or bad? You want to start with any W1, W2, W3, and now you're saying, yeah, for as long as W2 minus W3 is the same as U1. Is that good?
No.
No, because you say, I want it to be any, right? I want to be free. I don't want any conditions. Do you understand? But this is saying, you can only do it if this is true. Okay? All right? So therefore, because of this, you say, so this is a special requirement. It's a special condition. And we don't like impositions, right? We just want for anybody, okay? And so therefore the implication here is L onto? The answer is L is not onto. Did you understand? Okay? All right. Okay, so this exercise number 6, again, we met this before. This is the linear transformation from P2 to P2, where P of T and P2 is mapped to a T squared times P prime of T. Our problem is to find a basis for the range of L and a dimension. Of course, we answer these two questions same time, right? Okay, for the range of L. So how will we start doing this? So again, let's look at the typical element of P2. What will a P of T look like? If you have it, it's going to be AT squared plus BT plus C, right? And let's look at what L will do to P of T. What will L do to P of T? It will map it to what? T squared times the derivative, right, of P of T, which is 2AT plus B. Is that right? Okay, which you notice you can write as what? 2a t cubed plus bt squared. Okay, so this will be an element in the range of L. So can we answer the question?
Yes, it's a range.
So this looks like an a times 2t cubed, right? Plus a b times t squared, linear combination. So therefore, what is a basis for the range of L? 2t cubed, t squared, right? Is that a basis? Are we sure? Are they linearly independent?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right? Okay, so this is your basis for range L. And therefore, since there are two elements in the basis, that means to say that what?
Dimensions.
The dimension of range L is 2. Okay, so that's what you have there.